Welcome to the Good News Radio broadcast. Hello, this is Brenda Harris greeting you in the precious name of Jesus. Before Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. Have you ever heard the metaphor, burning the candle at both ends? I'll bet you know what that means. I would like to throw a thought out there into cyberspace. Maybe some of you will catch it and listen. You might actually like it. How does taking a day off sound? Maybe even two. In a row. Wow, what an innovative idea. I know what life is like for many. You pull your tired self out of bed to do all the jillion things that you have to do, especially if you have a family. How many of you feel like you are constantly working so hard that you never have time for yourself? You hardly ever take a vacation, and even if you do take a vacation, that vacation seems like a lot of work. Then, when you get home from your vacation, you wish you had a week off to recoup from your vacation. Been there, done that. Do you know that we all need time for rest? Our bodies need it. Our minds need it. If we take time to rest, our bodies can heal. Our minds can think. Our emotions can relax. That sounds like paradise to me. You may not have ever thought about this, but God was the one who came up with the idea of rest. In fact, God instituted the day of rest when He created the world. Scripture tells us that God rested on the seventh day after He created the world. Not because He was tired. God doesn't get tired. God just thinks that rest is great. He doesn't just think it, He knows it. God likes to admire what He has done. And God instituted the Sabbath in order for man to get the rest that he deserves. God knows how desperately his people need to rest. I know that we are now in the new covenant, but rest is still a great idea today. The book of Hebrews tells us to enter into God's rest. We need to take time to get close to God. We shouldn't just live our lives 90 miles to the second all the time. We need to slow down, take it easy, and spend time with God. We also need to take time for ourselves. Psalm 127 says, "It is vain to rise early and go to rest late, eating the bread of anxious toil." In the book of Mark, Jesus said, "Come away for a while to a desolate place in order to rest." Psalm 24 says, "He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters." Isaiah chapter 30 tells us, "Thus says the Holy One of Israel, in return and rest you shall be saved. In quietness and in trust shall be your strength." God speaks highly of rest. Rest can change your life for the better. How many of you are exhausted all the time? The busyness of life can drain you and you can become burnt out. God wants you to take some time off. No, really, it's a great idea. Don't feel guilty about taking time for yourself. God is not condemning you for taking a rest. We have to take our responsibilities seriously, but we need to take our rest as well. We need to take our time of relaxation seriously. Rest means to cease from labor. Do you realize that God even gave commandments to his people about letting the land take rest? Yes, he sure did. God saw rest as very important. Every 7 years, the land was supposed to rest. That's what God told the Israelites. That meant the farmers could not plant the fields for a whole year. The land had to rest. We should do that in our own land. Our farmers would reap huge harvests if they did that. That's what happened when God's people obeyed God for this command. They reaped a better harvest. Rest also means going to Jesus. "All ye that are weary and heavily laden, and he will give you rest." That means emotional rest. You can go to him when you are feeling grumpy and out of sorts. Just be honest with him and he will give you rest for your soul. How comforting is that? Well, it's so wonderful. I'll take that. In your life, be moved by what God wants. Trust in Him and don't be moved by guilt, but be moved by God's Holy Spirit. Let God guide you day by day. Let the healing balm of Gilead flow over your life. Take your rest, O my soul, for the Lord has been good to you. And now this concludes the message today. Again, this is Brenda Harris, blessing you in Christ's name. May God's face shine upon you and show you His great favor.